Another case of pole-related violence, this time in Datu Saudi Ampatuan and Maguindanao, where a man was injured in a shooting incident. Our correspondent Lori Mae Andiong joins us live for more details. So what more can you tell us, Lori Mae?
Yes, Kathy, one man was hurt during a shooting incident outside a polling center in Barangay Kabini in Datu Saudi Ampatuan in Maguindanao, 2:15 in the afternoon. He was identified as Russell Ibrahim, who was brought to hospital in Cotabato City due to the injury he sustained. According to the accounts of some voters, the gunman shot the victim up front outside the polling center. This prompted the supporters of both candidates in the barangay chairman position to throw rocks and casted stones against each other. There were gun bursts heard near the polling center coming from an unknown direction, and because of the commotion, the military assigned in the area gave warning shots to pacify the tension. But still, this went out of control as they continued casting stones, with just the rural health unit separating their positions. In the said barangay, two women are vying for the barangay chairman race. One is the incumbent chairwoman Baisal Manuto, and her opponent Gida Dimaukom, the sister-in-law of the slain mayor of Datu Saudi Ampatuan, Samsudin Dimaukom. Based on the report of the authorities, supporters of both candidates were already in tents this morning, and as the time nears for the closing of the election, both are trying to let their residents and followers vote before 3 o'clock. But because of the incident, the voting ended early and the electoral board brought the ballot boxes to a much safer place for the counting. Some electoral board also requested to just conduct their counting and canvassing at the municipal hall gymnasium. The PNP and the military also ensured them of their safety while doing the canvassing as of this moment. According to election officer of Datu Saudi Ampatuan, the counting and canvassing in Datu Saudi Ampatuan still continue as of this time. And that's the latest from my end. Lori Mae Andiong, ABS-CBN News.
Thank you for that, Lori Mae.